This illustration is describing the analysis of sliding of a block over a trolley. Here we are given that figure shows a trolley A of mass 20 kg over which a block B of mass 10 kg is placed. Here ground is smooth, but friction coefficient between block and trolley is 0.25. And it is saying if a horizontal force of 20 newton is applied on block, we are required to find acceleration of block and trolley. And we are also required to solve the case when force is 40 newton. Now, to solve this situation first, we analyze the limiting friction between block B and trolley A, which can be written as mu mg. And we are given that mass of block B here is 10 kilogram and friction coefficient is 0.25. This can be given as 0.25 multiplied by 10 and g. So, this will give us a value of 25 newton. That is the limiting friction between block and trolley. So, when the friction will approach to the value of 25 newton, then block B will start sliding with respect to trolley. So, here we can see at small values of F, both A and B will move together, and for which we can write the acceleration of the system, we can write as F divided by the total mass, which is 30 kilograms. So, with this acceleration, the whole system will move. Here, if we analyze the friction between trolley A and block B, then we can see if a force F is applied onto it, the friction will act on block B in backward direction, and on A, the reaction of this force will be in forward direction. And this friction is responsible for motion in trolley A. So, here if we write the equation for trolley A, then equation of motion for A we can write as the friction acting on it is responsible for motion of A, and mass of trolley A here is 20 kilogram multiplied by its acceleration, that is F by 30. And here we can write when this friction will approach to the value 25 newton, then block B will start sliding on block A. So, we can write this is equal to 25 for sliding between A and B. So, in this situation, the value of F we are getting is, this will be 75 by 2, that is 37.5 newton. That means when value of external force approaches 37.5 newton, then block B will start sliding over A and friction will be at limiting value 25 newton. Now, we can discuss the two cases. If capital F is equals to 20 newton, here we can see this is less than 37.5 newton. This implies acceleration of A is equals to acceleration of B, and this is equals to F by 30, that is equals to F we can write as 20 newton. So, this will be 2 by 3 meter per second square, which is the result of this problem. And if we continue this for if F is equals to 40 newton, which is greater than 37.5 newton, that means beyond this value, both the blocks will move independently and the value of friction is at 25 newton. So, acceleration of block A we can write as friction by its mass, which is 20. The value of friction will be limiting, that is 25 by 20. So, this is giving us a value 1.25 meter per second square. And acceleration of block B, we can give as F minus friction divided by its mass, that is 10. The value of F is 40 and friction here is 25. So, this will be 15 by 10, that is 1.5 meter per second square. So, these are the results of the problem when external applied force is 40 newton.